Never in the history of the NHS have junior doctors gone.
Action by doctors
the right thing to do
as
they've refused to negotiate is to publish
how
what the
is it that these sums add up? They just do
no
not.
One working legal hours
that
will lose out in anywhere
created
at all.
That has brought these strikes on.
Hello, my name is Michael Sheen, and I want to show my support for the junior doctors in their protests against the new contract that's being imposed upon them by the Health Secretary. Junior doctors are the absolute backbone of the NHS, and the NHS is being threatened from all sides. They work so incredibly hard in really difficult conditions, and these are the people who we entrust to look after us and our loved ones when they're at their weakest, at their most needy, at their most vulnerable. So surely we should look after them and make sure that they don't have to work longer hours for less pay and have these new working conditions that are totally exploitative forced upon them. Nobody wins in this situation. We don't want to force junior doctors out of the NHS, out of the country. We want to support them. We want to keep them there. We want to give them incentives to stay and look after us and work as hard as they already do. Patients' safety is going to be compromised, inevitably, if this is forced through. So I hope that the Health Secretary will work with junior doctors and not against them. And I want to show my support for them. So good luck with the protest and all the very best.
As somebody who has been in and out of hospital a few times in my life and has had family members rely very heavily on the NHS and the fantastic treatment that we receive there, I'd like to throw my weight behind the junior doctors campaign for better conditions, wages, hours. You have my absolute support, which is why I say support our junior doctors and keep our NHS safe. Thank you.
I'm Cyrus Todiwala. This is my wife, Bervin Todiwala, of Cafe Spice Namaste. We operate 4 establishments in the food and beverage industry within London. In our industry, it is commonly known that we are overworked and sometimes underpaid. In the medical profession, it also applies to the same thing. If a junior doctor is fatigued, overworked, and underpaid, it can be disastrous for the person he or she is treating. Same as in the food industry, it can lead to severe accidents. In the medical profession, it can lead to death, it can lead to more complications in a patient. So we feel very, very strongly that the junior doctors within the UK need to be better appreciated and need to be better rewarded for all the work that they put in. It also helps to make it very clear that whilst people are contemplating whether or not they should go into the profession because it is undervalued, Britain might require to import people in the future. To avoid that, we need to start now by looking after the people that are homegrown, better paid, better valued, better appreciated for the 7-8 years of education that they put in without specialization within their education to make a good living for themselves and to have a successful career. So we need the whole of Britain to back this effort and make sure that the NHS is not ignored and it's not let down.
We need to get behind the junior doctors now.
I'm Dr. Pixie McKenna. I was a junior doctor 20 years ago. I regularly worked long hours in unsafe conditions. I don't want to see this happening again. Junior doctors are the lifeblood of the NHS. Please support them.
Hi, I'm Robert Lindsay. I'd just like to offer a word of support to all you junior doctors working so tirelessly for the National Health Service. the government really have to keep their hands off the National Health Service and these newly enforced contracts, which I gather 20,000 people marched in protest recently. Well, sadly, I couldn't be there, but I'm offering this opportunity just to offer my support and my entire family's support. We support the National Health Service. We support you. Good luck and keep up the good work.
When I was a little girl, I had double pneumonia, which led to my left lung collapsing and then having bronchiectasis, which meant I was in that hospital a lot of my childhood years. I was under the care of UCS and Hammersmith Hospital. They gave me the best treatment I could possibly have. I was looked after, I was nurtured, I felt safe, I was in good hands. And if the NHS gets these cuts and doctors aren't allowed to do what they do, if I was having this illness today rather than then, who knows what may happen. But I owe my life to the NHS.
The NHS is not perfect, but it is astonishing. It's an organisation devoted entirely to the care of the sick. And it is one of the wonders of the world, and one that we should be proud of, and that we should be defending against the current attacks it's under. Particularly the attacks on junior doctors and their new contracts, which are going to run them into the ground. So please, join me. Support junior doctors and keep the NHS safe. Thank you.
Hello, my name's Rufus Hound. I'm speaking to you from a hotel room because I am bloody jazzy. When we're sick and when we're ill, when we're poorly or broken or been smashed up, when the world has got us by the scruff of the neck and is holding us underwater, who do we turn to? Who is it that can make us better and unbreak us and fix us? It's you. And the idea that the work you do is undervalued, that you are devalued or demonized, that every mistake made is dragged out into the light and every triumph is cast into shadow, every pound that you earn through intelligence and compassion and training and wisdom and talent. And to have some twonk who's never done a compassionate thing in his life turn around and say these contracts need renegotiation, we need a 7-day health service, you know, for too long doctors have had it all their own way, is sickening, and it's criminal, and it is a deliberate misrepresentation of the truth of you and your job and your right to march. You are right to say we will not stand for this. The hours you've put in study and physically the hours, you know, junior doctors have to work when you first get in there, the things that you see, the things that you have to deal with. I just look at a little weasel like Jeremy Hunt and I think, what right do you have to even be in the same room as doctors? Now look, you might be Jeremy Hunt's best mate. And who am I? Some twonky actor, some, you know, panel show tit. Who am I to judge? And philosophically, you are right to a point. I don't think I'm particularly wonderful, but I do think you are. I do think there is no higher calling in the world than helping your fellow man, and to do it as directly and immediately and carefully and compassionately as you do it. You know, to then have somebody turn up and go, that's not okay, that contract's not right, here's a 20% pay cut, is not on. So stick two fingers up, march hard, demand more, you're worth every penny, and a damn sight more than the Minister of Health will ever be worth. Good luck.